Hello everyone, welcome back to Scalar Academy YouTube channel. Myself Vamsi. In this tutorial we will be learning about graph traversal algorithms, and namely breadth first search and depth first search. So coming to prerequisites, it will be good if you know how to represent a graph using either Java or C++, but in this particular video I will be coding in C++. Okay, so yeah, without wasting any time, let's get started. Before starting, if you are visiting channel for the first time, please don't forget to subscribe, and if you like the content, please hit that like button up. And if you have any queries or questions, please let us know in the comment section. Now let's first discuss a breadth first search, then we'll see depth first search. Okay, so probably if you have seen my earlier video which was on trees, you might end up hearing this word called a BFS over there. So yes, like what is the difference? So in this video we will be talking about graph. So the same topic now, BFS. So there also BFS, here also BFS, both are same, right? No. Okay, so these are all different because the data structure has been different. So trees and graphs. So again, so you might, if you know what is a graph earlier, so you might think that yes, we do have nodes here, we do have adjacencies here, like we do have edges and we will travel from one edge node to another node. Okay, that's it, right? So yes, but the difference is in trees, usually there will be no cycles. So what is a cycle? Let's say you have a node like this. Okay, you have a tree something like this. So now you will start visiting from here. Okay, you will go here, then you will go here, then you will go here, again you will come here again. So it is never ending process, right? Just because of the fact that you never see a root which is a null, right? So it will go in an infinite loop or infinite recursive calls. Now what is the solution? So basically, so you won't see this kind of situation in trees, okay, but in graphs we do have that situation. Okay, so where you will be having cyclic graphs. Okay, so graphs are being, we have a different graphs, okay, directed, undirected, cyclic and acyclic graphs. So here we need to handle both. Okay, so for that we are having something special for graphs. Okay, so let's see. So first we'll have we'll see one example where we can find BFS for that particular graph. We'll see couple of examples until we get some familiar about how BFS works in a graph, then we'll jump on to the logical, then we'll see coding part. Okay, let's start. So let's see, you have a graph like this. So 1 and 2, then 4 and 5. Okay, so from here you will have a, so here, then here. Okay, now first you will start from here, 1. Okay, you will visit this guy, and let's assume this is your output. Okay, now tell me what are all the adjacents to the 1. These are all the adjacents. So what is mean by adjacents? So the nodes are vertices. So basically we call these particular things as a vertices in a graph. In tree we call them as a nodes. Okay, so here can I say there is some path from 1 to 2 and 1 to 3. So if there exists a path, then I can say that they are adjacencies. Okay, so from 1 there is a path from 2 to 2. Okay, from 1 there is a path to 2 and 3. So I will first visit 1, then I will go to 2, then I will visit 3. Okay, breadth. Now what is the next element? So I will go to 2. Okay, and I will travel. Okay, I will go to all the adjacencies of 2. Okay, what are all the adjacencies of a 2? It's a 4, 5 and 1. Okay, so did we visited 1 already? Yes, we have seen 1 already. So we'll print 4 and 5. Done. So now we will go to 3. So what are all the adjacencies of 3? It's a 1 and 5. So we have visited 1 already here, and we have also visited 5. 2 done 3 done 1 done 4 done 5 done. Okay, so we have visited 5 as well. Okay, now you will go to 4. Okay, what are all the adjacencies of a 4? 2 5 6. Okay, so you have visited 2, you have visited 5, right? So you will left with 6. So you will add a visit here, like you will visit that particular 6. Now it's a 5. So what are all the adjacents of a 5? 3, 6, 4, 2. Okay, 3, 6, 4, 2. So you are done with 2, you are done with 3, you are done with 4, you are done with 6. So you won't add anything. Okay, from you will at last you will come to 6. What is a 6? So what are all the adjacents of a 6? 4, 5. Okay, so you have visited 4 already. You have visited 5 already. So can I say that now on this node, I have visited all the nodes. Visited all nodes, all vertices. Done. Okay, so hope you got some idea how BFS works. Now we'll see another example. Okay, another good example. So that you will get some clear picture about how this BFS algorithm works. Okay, so let's take another tree and we'll see. So graph, sorry. 1, graph 2 and 3. And for 2, you have a 4. And for 2, there is a 5 as well. And there is a cycle. And you have another node. Yeah. Unsurprisingly, we have another graph here. Let's say 7 and 8. Okay. 7 and 8. So, is this a valid graph? You might have that question. Is this a valid graph? Yes, this is a valid graph. So, basically, this entire graph will cause one component and this one entire graph will cause another component graph. Okay, so there will be a lot of questions, like there is some important questions based upon this component graphs. Okay, so hopefully we'll see them in next videos. So here now let's say I will start with 1. Okay, I will start with 1. So I will put a 1 here. Now what are all the adjacents to the 1? Say 2 1 3. So I will pick up a 2. Now I will go to all the adjacents of a 2. So who are all the 3. So now I will go to adjacents of a 3. So it's a 5 4 1. Okay, so 1 is already visited, 5 and 4. So you will have a 5 and 4. Done. So I have completed 1, I have completed 2. Now I have 3. So 1 4, that's it, right? So I have already visited 1, I have already visited 4, so I am done with 3. So now I will go to 5. So for 5, who are all the adjacents? It's a 2, 4, 6. Okay, 2, 4, 6. So 2 already done, 4 already done. So there is only left with 6. We'll add that. Now we'll go to 4. Okay, so for 4, 2, 5, 6, 3. Okay, 2 done, 3 done, 5 done, 6 done. Okay, there is nothing to add. Now we'll go to 6. Okay, so for 6, who are all the adjacents? 5 and 4. Okay, 4 done, 5 done. Okay, so on this note, I'm done. So there is nothing to visit again. Now here, one thing. So is this also a graph? We need to traverse this as well. Okay, so I will again start from this note. Okay, so then I will add 7. Okay, now who are all the adjacents to the 7? It's a 8. Now we'll complete at 7 and now we'll go to 8. So is there anything connected to the 8? Yes, it's a 7. So already 7 is visited. So we are done with here. Now there is nothing to add to the next. So this is how it works. Okay, now let's see how our logic will be for BFS. Okay, so listen carefully. So which is very, very important concept for any interviews. If you are attempting, like if you are attempting some good product based companies, these are all the questions that are going to target. Okay, you might think that this is just a traversal algorithm. Don't think like that. This is beyond that. Okay, this is beyond that. You can solve a lot of problems using this particular BFS and DFS algorithms in a graph. Okay, now let's take one good graph and we'll try to build our logic by using that graph. Okay, let's say I have it graph something like this. 1, then 2, 3, 4. Okay, I will have 5, 6, and 7, 8, 9. Okay, so from here. Okay, so first thing, so whenever you have given a graph, you need to draw an adjacency list. Okay, you need to form an adjacency list of that particular graph. So you might be wondering what is adjacency list. So you can consider, if you are a C++ coder, so you might think as a vector of list. Okay, And generally, there were two ways to represent a graph. So one is adjacency matrix and another one is adjacency list. So in adjacency matrix, you will represent the graph in terms of ones and zeros, where you will be taking vertices to the vertices. Okay, so how many, like if there were 9 vertices in a graph, you will take 9 columns and 9 rows. It's a 9x9 matrix. And you will be, if there is a path from one particular vertices to one particular vertices, let's say 1, 2, 3, you will represent a 1 over there. If there is no path between 1 and 3, you will represent 0. Okay, so it contains only zeros and ones. Okay, so that is how adjacency matrix is going to look like. And while coming to adjacency list, so here you will be having a vector of list. Okay, let's see how. So adjacency list. So basically, let's say you will pick up node 1, okay, vertices 1, and tell me who are all the adjacent to the particular vertices, like 1, so 2, 4, right? 2, 1, 4. You are done with 1. Now you will go to next, you will go to 2. Who are all the adjacents to the 1, 2, 2, sorry. So 1, 3, and 5. You will have completed this. Now you will go to 3. Who are all the adjacents to the 3? It's a 2, 7, 4. 2, 7, 4. Now you will go to next one. This 4. Who are all the adjacents to the 4? It's a 1, 3. 1, 3. Then you will go to 5. It's a 2, 6. Now you will go to 6. It's a 5, 7. Now you will go to 7. It's a 3, 8, 6. Now we'll go to a 8. So it's a 7, 9. Then you will go to a 9, it's a 8. Okay, so from 7 you have 3. Okay, done. So this is the adjacency list looks like. So you can call this as a, you can consider this as a vector index. Okay, so one index. And for one index, you will be having a list. Okay, list means you can consider this array. Okay, vector of array. So where you will be having 2, 4 and all. Okay, so the idea is you will stick to that particular vertex. Okay, then you will traverse to that particular array so that you will get an all the adjacencies of that particular vertex. So that's it. So now we'll see how we will implement BFS by using this for this particular graph. Okay, so you will have a visitor array or vector. Why this? So earlier, so what is the problem that we have identified in a trees? So you are visiting the same node for the multiple times. Okay, so the same thing happens in graph as well. Yes, right? Don't you think? Yes. So to reduce that particular problem, we are having a visitor array where you will be keeping all the visited vertices. Okay, so with zeros and ones. Okay, you can consider zero means not visited, one means visited. So by default, we will be filling them with a zeros by means that we are not visited. Okay, so how much indexes we need to take? So it will be, so if you have n vertices, you need to take n plus 1 vector or array, just because of the fact that we will be starting from the 1th index, 1th vertices. Okay, so let's take an array, looks like this. So we do have 9 vertices, so I will have to take 10. Okay, so starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so this. Okay, now you will fill all the zeros over there. You can consider, okay, if you don't like consuming a lot of memory, you can use a bool as well, which takes 1 byte only. Okay, for bool, you can consider false as an not visited and 1 as a visited, sorry, true as a visited. And also you will be having another thing, what is called a queue data structure. What is a queue? A queue is a data structure which follows the principles of first in, first out. Like whoever comes into the first, they will go out first. That's it. Okay, now we'll see how that works. Okay, so this is a queue and this is a visitor array. Okay, so first we'll start with this one. Now tell me, is that one visited? No. So what you will do? So you will call a BFS, like assume like that. Okay, so now you are visited, sorry, BF in BFS. Now you will mark this guy. this particular one as a visited. Okay, one has visited. So one. Now you will enqueue this particular vertex into the queue. Okay, you will say one. Okay, done. Now what I need to do? I need to visit all the adjacents of a one, right? So I will iterate in a loop. Okay, so I will enqueue all the adjacencies of a this one. Okay, if they are not visited. Okay, if they are visited, no problems. They will be in my output, right? So if they are not visited, I will push enqueue all of them into my queue. So it will be first 2, then 4. So on this note, I can say that I'm done with 1. So whenever I'm done with this particular guy, I will push that into the my output. Like I will print that into my output. So let's say this is my output. Okay, so 1. I got 1. Now, is that queue empty? No. I will pick up this guy. And I will visit all the adjacents of that particular vertices. Now before that, what I will do, I will mark this guy as a visitor. Okay, so 2. Okay, here 1. Now I will enqueue all the adjacents of 2. So what are all they? 1, 3, 5. 1 is already visited, right? 1 is already visited. Is 3 visited? No. So I will push that 3. Now is that 5 visited? No. So I will push 5 as well. Done. Now what I will do? So on that node, I can say that I am done with the 2. So I will erase that. Okay. Now the next one is 4. Okay. So first I will mark 4 as a visited. Now I will go through all the adjacents of a 4. So who are all the adjacents of a 4? It's a 1 and 3. So is 1 already visited? Yes, already visited. Okay. So sorry, I forgot to override this. Yeah. Okay. So now 1 already visited. Yes. So is 3 already visited? Yes. Is 3 also visited, right? So you are done with 4. So you will print output that. Now you will come to 3. Okay. Now what are all the adjacents to the 3? 2, 7, 4. Okay. Is 2 visited? Yes. 2 is already visited. Then 7 is visited? No. So you will mark 7 as a visited and push it to the queue. Now is 4 visited? Yes. 4 is already visited. Okay, so you don't need to worry about that. You have completed this and this. Okay, so you are done with 3 and you will with that the output. Now 5. So who are all the adjacents to the 5? 2, 1, 6. Is 2 visited? Yes, it's already visited. So no work with 2. Is 6 visited? No. So you will mark it as a visited and you will push it to queue. Now, so you are done with 5 as well. So you will print it to the output board. Okay. Now it's a 7. Who are all the adjacents to the 7? 3. So 3 done. Yes, already visited. So is 8 visited? No. So you will mark it as a visited and push it to the queue. Now 6. 6 already visited. No work. Okay. Done. So I am done with 7 as well. So I will print it to my output board. Now 6. So who are all the adjacents to the 6? It's a 5 and 7. 5 already visited. Yes. 7 already visited. Yes. Okay. No work. So you are done with 6 as well. Okay, we'll print 6 here. Done. Now it's a 8. Who are all the adjacents of 8? 7 and 9. So 7 already visited. Yes. So no work. So is 9 visited? No. So you will mark it as a visited and you will push that to the queue. And on this note, you can say I'm done with 8. Okay. So you will put that in the output box. Now it's a 9. Okay. So who are all the adjacents to the 9? It's a 8. So is 8 visited? Yes, it's a visitor. So no work. So on that note, I can say that I'm done with 9 as well. So did we covered all the vertices? Let's see. Okay. So did I visited 1? Yes. 2? Yes. 3? Yes. 4? Yes. 5? Yes. 7? Yes. 6? Yes. 8? 9. Done. So this is how binary best first search algorithm looks like. Okay. So without wasting any time, let's go and code for this particular approach. So now let's discuss the C++ code of an BFS algo. Now first we will be taking 2 inputs from the user. One is vertices and the edges. So vertices are the number of vertices we will be having in particular graph. And again, I am saying that it's an 1-based indexing graph. Okay. So means I will be starting the vertices names from 1. Okay. Now edges. So why we need edges? So it will represent the how many edges we are having in entire graph, so that we can iterate that many times and we can form an adjacency list. Okay, so we'll see that now. So for that, to form an adjacency list, I will be creating array of vector. Okay, where so for one particular array we will be having indexes, right? So how many indexes we will be having? So vertices are 9. Okay, so since we are considering one based indexing, we will be using vertices plus 1. Okay, plus 1, and then it's a vector. Okay, so here in loop we are iterating throughout the number of edges we will be having, and for every time we will be taking two inputs. One is from vertice, another one is a two vertices. Okay, so we will be taking that and we will be forming an graph adjacency. So why two? So you are forming u2v and v2u. So why? So basically, since it's an undirected graph, okay, so we might have an both sides, right? So let's say I have a path from 1 to 2. It is equivalently to 2 to 1 as well, right? So that's why. It's okay if you use only one thing, like if you form only one edge, that's totally okay. Okay, not a big problem. Now let's see. So now I'm assuming that you have an adjacency list, okay, which is having all the edges. Now we will be having a visited vector. So where initially we will be storing all the zeros. Okay, initially you will be storing all the zeros in it. Now we will be starting from the 1. Okay, always my starting point is 1. So I represent the BFS starts from 1. So here I am passing visited vector and adjacency list. Okay, now I will go here. Now here what happened? So first, whatever I started, like, so I will make that start as visitor first, right? 1 represents visitor, 0 represents not visitor. So I will make it as a 1. Then I will create a queue. Okay, in that queue I will firstly push that starting point. Okay, now I will iterate through the queue until that queue is empty. Okay, so since my queue is not empty now, I will enter into the loop and I will make an friend. Like, what is a friend happens? So it will give me that top element. Okay, so first element. So what is the first element? It's a 1 now. So my current vertices is 1. Now I will pop that 1. So I will remove that. Okay, now I will print that onto my output screen. Now I will iterate throughout that, like I will move to all the adjacents of that current vertex, right? 1. So this is how I can use now. So I will, let's assume, okay, so for from 1 first vertex we do have a 2 1 3. Okay, first I will go to 2 and I will check whether if that is a visited or not. If that is a visited, it could have been a 1. If that is not, a 0. So if it is 0, I will enter into this particular if block. Okay, now if it is 0, what I will do? I will first mark it as a visited, then I will push it to my queue, right? I am doing that. I will then I will go to 3. Okay, now I will do the same. Okay, now after doing, I will come here again loop. Okay, so my queue is not empty. So I will repeat the same for current value vertex is 2 now, right? So I have popped out that 1. Okay, so it will do all these things until this queue is empty. When this will become empty, it will become empty when all the vertices are visited. Okay, so what visited vector will become 1, all ones. Okay, so this is how a code looks like for a normal BFS, like if it's a 1 a component graph. But we have discussed something different, right? What is that something different? So here you might have a graph like this. So here, right? So I will pass 1 here and I will done with this particular graph. Now what about this graph? So I have to repeat the same again, right? I need to repeat the again. So since I don't know what is the starting point, what is the starting point always. So what I will do now, I will return a loop. Okay, let's say which will start from 0 and goes on till vertex plus 1. Okay, and I will check if that particular I is visited. If it is not visited, okay, I will go. Okay, so first 1, okay, I will go. I will call BFS and visited and adjacents. Done. Okay, so I will visit all this graph, right? I'm done with this graph. Now again come. So I will come after this loop and I will say increment to 1 to 2. So I will make my 1 as 2 now. So 2 is already visited. Yes, it's a visitor. So why? So I am passing this visitor as my reference. Okay. So whenever it will visited, it will get updated here as well. And I will mark it as 1. So 3 visited, 4 visited, now 5. I is 5 now. So is 5 visited now? No, 5 is not visited. So what I will do? I will make a call to BFS. Okay. Now it will do this thing. So again, I will come back and I will say 6. 6 already visited. Done. So this is how code looks like. Okay. So nothing much. Okay. So it's just an loop. So I will remove that here and I will make int I equal to 1 and I will say iterate to vertex is I plus plus. Okay. So if visited of I is not equal to 0, if not equal to 1, I need to say BFS of I and visited and adjacency. That's it. This is how the code looks like. Okay. So if you are in an interview, it will be good. Okay. So interview expects you to write this coding, like algo for to have in multiple components. But if you are still have that doubt what to write, you can ask your interviewer. Okay. So can I assume, is there only one component in this graph or multiple components exist? Okay. So the complexity of this approach looks like, you can guess, right? So yeah, it will be mostly big O of N since we are visiting all the vertices. And you might think, yes, we are doing for a couple of times, right? So we are calling here and we are having, in worst case, we will be, so let's say it's a one component, then it will be big O of N first time. Now again, I am calling all these vertices. So you might think it's a big O of N plus 1, N into N. But if you carefully observe, it will end up at N plus N. Okay. So I can say that max, it will be big O of N. And coming to space complexity. So here you will be using this. Okay. Okay. Visitor array. So for that, you will be using big O of N, like big O of vertices, number of vertices. Then also you are using a queue here, right? A queue. So again, at worst, it might take big O of N, right? So you can have a big O of N plus 1. It will be, you can say that, but it's okay. So if you can say big O of N as well, okay, be accurate. Okay, so figure it, try to figure it on your own. Okay, that will be a good practice. Okay, cool. Now let's discuss the DFS. What is a DFS? A depth first search depth. Okay, depth. Okay, let's see. Okay, so we'll consider a small graph. Okay, so 1 and from 1 to 3 and from 2 it's a 4 and it's a 5 and 3 to 5 and here. Okay, so this is a graph you have given and you asked you to find the DFS of this particular graph. So how do you start? So let's say we'll start from 1. Okay, I will say 1 now. So in BFS, we have moved simultaneously to all the adjacents of a particular vertex. But in DFS, we don't do that. We'll pick up one of its adjacent and we'll traverse all of its particular adjacents. Okay, so let's say. So now what are all the adjacents of a 1? Say either 2 and 3. Okay, we'll pick up 2 first. Okay, now we'll pick up 2. Okay, so from 2, what are all the adjacents to the 2? 4 and 1. Is 1 already visited? Yes, it's already visited. So we don't need that. So we'll say we'll go to 4 now. Now from 4, what are all the possible adjacents? 2, 3, 5, 6. Right? Now is 3 visited? No. So you will say I will go to 3. Now I am currently here. Now what are all the adjacents of a 3? Say 1, 5, 4. So 4 already visited. 1 already visited. Now I'll go to 5. Now from 5, who are all the adjacents of a 5? 3, 4, 6. 3 already visited, 4 already visited. Now I will go to 6. So from 6, is there any unvisited? Is there what are all the adjacents? It's a 4, 5. So 4 is already visited, 5 is already visited. So nothing to go. Okay. Now I will check all other vertices where I left. Okay. So in this way, it looked like this is the DFS of this particular graph. Is there any other solution? Yes. So at beginning, instead of going at the 2, I will go at the 3 now. Okay, so first I will visit 1, then I will go to 3 path. Now, what is the from 3? What are all the possible ways we have? I can go to 1, I can go to 5, I can go to 4. So now I will pick up. I say I know that 1 is already visited. Now I have to go either 4 or 5. So I will go to 5. Okay. Now from 5, what are all the adjacencies? 3, 4, 6. Okay. Now I know that 3 is already visited. Okay. 3 is already visited. Now I can choose 6 now. I will choose 6. Okay. Now from 6, I have 5, 4. Okay. 5 is already visited. Okay. I will go to 4. Okay. I will go to 4. Now currently I'm at here. Now what are all the adjacencies of 4? 2, 3, 5, 6. Okay. So 3 visited, 5 visited, 6 visited. So I will go to 2. Okay. So from 2, I will go to either 4 or 1. Okay. So since both are already visited, I can stop here. That's it. So this is also a correct solution. Okay. So on this note, I can say that there might be a different solutions for one particular graph. Okay. So it depends upon how you are going and what text you are currently picking up. Okay. So now let's simply jump into our logic. Okay. So I will take up simple a graph. Let's say I have a 1, then 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is one component. Have another component, let's say 7 and 8. Okay. So now first step, we need to find the adjacency of this particular graph, adjacency list. So how does it looks like? So we have first one index. So first vertex, who are all the adjacencies of the first? 2 comma 3. So and for 2, it's a 1 comma 4. And for 3, it's a 1 comma 5. And for 4, it's a 2 comma 6 comma 5. And for a 5, it's a 3 comma 4. And for 6, it's a 4. For 7, it's a 8. And 8, it's a 7. Okay. This is the adjacency of this particular graph. Now let's see. So first thing is first, we do have one visited array. Okay. Where it will be by default, it will be marked as all the zeros. So here, since we have 8 vertices, it will be 8 plus 1. It's a totally 9. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Okay. So let's write the indexes of this 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Now, so all these were filled with zeros. Zeros. Yeah. Now, how this works? Now, basically, this DFAC is a recursive algorithm. Okay. So if you are in an interview, they are not interested in recursive manner. So you know how to write, right? By using stack. Okay. You can write this in an iterator approach by using stack. Okay. But let's see. Okay. So I will tell you recursive approach, but it's your job to write the iterative approach. Okay. So it's very easy. I gave a hint, right? Try it on your own. So let's say first I will start from 1. Okay. So while discussing the code of BFS, I have shown you how to, if the given graph is a component based graph. So if you have different components, I have shown you how to traverse to that, right? So for I is equal to 1 to vertices plus 1. Okay. If that vertices not visited, I can say that do DFS of that particular vertex. That's it. Okay. This is how it looks like. So first we'll start from a DFS of a 1. Okay. So from here, what are all the ways? So I have 2 and 3. Okay. I have 2 and 3. So I will pick up this time. I will go with 2 side. Okay. So DFS of 2. So before moving on to DFS of 2, I will mark DFS 1 as visited. 1 as visited. Now since I started 2, I will mark it as a visited. Okay. Now from 2, where I can go. Okay. So on my output board, I can say that till now I have 1 and 2. Okay. So now again, what are the adjacencies of 2? It's a 1 and 4. Okay. So I know that 1 is already visited and I will go with 4 now. So DFS of 4. Okay. Cool. 4 done. 2 done. 1 as well done. Okay. 1 is also visited. Now So from 4, who are all the adjacents? So before moving on, I will mark it as a visitor. Now, who are all the adjacents? It's a 2, 6, 5. Okay. Since I know that 2 is already visited. Okay. I will go with next element called 6. Okay. 6. So before moving on, I will mark it as a 1. UFS of 6. Okay. Cool. Now, who are all the adjacents of 6? It's a 4. Okay. I know that 4 is already visited. Right. Visited. Now, I will go with, so since we are here, so 6, we have been to 4, okay. Now for 4, we have been done with 6, okay. So we come here, okay, we'll come here. So for 4, we have another option called DFS of 5, right. So there is no going from here. So after 6, we have only 4. 4 is already visited. So we'll come back to the top, like previous call. And we'll go to the next adjacency of that particular vertices. So it's a 5. Okay, I will mark 5 as a 1 and I will go to the 5 now. So for 5, it's a 3 and 4. Okay, so first I will go to check with 3. So is 3 visited? No. So I will mark it as a visited and I will go DFS of 3. Okay, now how is it look like? So since I am at 3, who are all the adjacents of 3? It's a 1 and 5. Okay, 1 and 5. So 1 already visited, 5 already visited, okay, 1 already visited and 5 already visited. So there is no midway from 3, okay, it's blocked. So I will go to top. So for 5, so 3 done and 4 left. So is 4 already visited? Yes, visited. Now again I will go to 4. So out of 4 is also done, 5 is also done. Now from top of the 4, I will go to 2, okay. So is there anything left in 2? No. From again I will go here, there is nothing in here as well, okay. So we left with 3, so 3 is already visited. So till now we have on our output 1 2 4 6 5 3, okay. So happens stop, okay. So this is what happens. Now what I will do, so I will go to my main now. So all this happens for first one, okay. So first iteration. So I is equal to first. Now what I will do, I will increment my I to 2. Okay, so is 2 visited? Yes, 3 visited, 4 visited, 5 visited, 6 visited. Now currently I am at 7. So 7 is not visited. Okay, what I will do? So I will make a call to DFS of a 7. Okay, so I will mark it as a visited and I will put it on my output. Now what happens? So from 7, who are all the adjacents? It's 8. I will make a DFS of 8, mark it as a 1. Okay, so from 8, who are all the adjacents? It's a 7. 7 is already visited. Okay, so block. Okay, I will come here. Is there anything to visit from 7? No. So I will return to main. So from main, I will increment my I. So it's 8 now. 8 is already visited. So that's it. Okay, so did we cover all the vertices? 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so I highly recommend you to take another graph and try out this approach. Okay, so it's very, very important. Okay, so now let's see the coding part of this particular DFS. Now let's discuss the C++ code of our DFS algorithm. So it's the same like before, like till creating an adjacency list, same as BFS. Okay, so we have seen that earlier. So till here, it's the same. Okay, so after you have adjacency list, we will be doing something different. Okay, so not much. Okay, so let's see. So first we will be having a vertices. Okay, so visited array. Okay, where we will be initializing with a 0 by default. If it is visited, we will be marking it as a 1. Okay, then so here I am assuming in case of components. Okay, we have different components to visit. Okay, so if it is not, it's very simple, right? So you will say a DFS of, you will start with 1 and you will go visited. And you will go adjacents. That's it. So it's as simple as that. If since it is a different components, it has different components, I am making it as a for loop and I am traversing to the all the vertices and I am checking if that particular vertex is visited, I won't go anywhere. If that particular is not visited, I will call DFS. Okay, so since one is not visited, I will call DFS for 1 and I will come here. Okay, I will come here. So since my start is 1, right, then I will say, so I will take visited vector and adjacency Now I will marking a visited of start as a 1 since I started visiting. So, and I will print the start as well. Okay. Now I will iterate through the all the adjacents of a particular start. Okay. So let's see. So first I got, let's say I have an adjacency from 1 to 2. So I will pick up 2 and I will start DFS. Okay. So here. So again, I will go to make a recursive call for 2 and I will again start, right? So if there is a 2 has 3 and I will again start for 3. So it's gone like that. So since that is why it's called as a depth wise. Okay. So it will reach till the depth. So till the last vertex. And then if it does particular vertex doesn't have any next vertex to go, then it will make a call to come back. Okay. It will go to previous call, then it will go to previous, and it will, from that previous call, if there is any adjacency to visit, then it will do that. Okay. So I will keep on doing that. And if that happens, okay, so I will come back here. And now I'm done with 1. Now I will check with 2. Since 2 is visited, again 3 visited, 4 visited, 5 visited, 6 visited, 7. Yes. So I hope you have remembered our example, right? 7 is not visited. So I will make a call to 7. So I will mark 7 as visited here. Okay. I will print 7 in my output board and I will go through all the adjacency of a 7. Okay. Now what is the adjacency of a 7? It's 8, right? So I know that it's a not visited. So I will make a call to DFS of 8. Okay. I will visit that again and I will mark it as a visit and I will print it on my output board. And from 8, there is only 7, which is already visited. Okay. Nothing to go. Okay, so I will come back to this loop. That's how it works. Okay, so that's as simple as that. Okay, so again, I'm saying that these are two algorithms are very, very important in perspective of interviews. Okay, if you are aiming for the high, so please don't try to not to skip these algos. Okay, so please try to practice as much of problems you can. Okay.